Elevation Tech.
Hello. What's up? Welcome back to Elevation Tech. My name is Josiah, here to improve your knowledge of tech. Now today we're doing something a little different. If you've seen a few of my most recent videos, I've been focusing a little more on photography content. And yet again, we're going down that route because today I'm going to show you how I think a street photography point of view video could be made relatively cheap without a GoPro. This is a smartphone adapter that came with one of my microphones. It came with the Rode Video Micro. And as you can see here, I have this little plate on the bottom that didn't come with this adapter. This actually is its own adapter. What it is an adapter. You can see here I have one that's not assembled. I bought this for $6 on Amazon. It was like $7.50 after tax. What it does is it enables you to put your camera and your smartphone together like this. This is just a quick demo. I don't actually have my smartphone with me. Now I can put a smartphone on top of this camera, which will enable me to take photos as well as record video. Now with the camera that you're watching right now, I can connect my smartphone to it with an app and have a sort of viewfinder that lets me see what the camera sees, control all of its settings, take pictures remotely, that sort of thing. Now where this can come in handy is if you're walking around taking street photography photos and you have your phone attached and connected, then you can record the screen and it'll show your viewers exactly what your camera is seeing. I've seen some street photography videos where there's a GoPro mounted to their chest and it looks good and they can kind of show what the camera is looking at, the back of it, but it's not quite exactly what the camera sees. And a lot of times I don't really know what they're looking at anyway. I can't tell what settings they're changing, but if you connect this smartphone app, all the settings will be on screen. Now for film photography, obviously with something like this, there's no smartphone app, so you're probably not going to be connecting a smartphone app for this. You could, however, use a light meter on top in order to correctly meter for the lighting environment for something like this, which doesn't have any sort of, it has a light meter, but it's very old. Alternatively, you can put your phone in this adapter and just record as you walk around. It wouldn't be quite the same as a GoPro, but it would be pretty close because it'd still be showing what you're walking around. I'll give you some examples later of what both of these could look like. As of right now, I've probably talked way too much for this intro. Let's go take some photos. I forgot to empty my SD card, so I only have like 400 pictures. That should be more than enough for this, so we're gonna go take some photos now. So this is where you might record a voiceover for your video. If you've been watching this tutorial, that's pretty cool because this seems pretty straightforward. I really just wanted an excuse to make a point of view street photography video. So some pros and cons that I found with this setup.
Pros, you don't need a GoPro, which is great because those are expensive. We have one, but it's not a new one, and new ones are really expensive. It's cheap because you already have a smartphone, most likely, and most any smartphone footage can basically rival a GoPro. It's good quality. I mean, my phone takes really smooth video. It has a hyper smooth mode. If you're using one of the new iPhones, they also have a hyper smooth mode. If you go the screen recording route, you can record the settings on screen, but personally, I found that video to be too shaky to watch. Another great bonus is that you get all the sounds of the camera with your smartphone recording, which I enjoyed. When you're walking around, you'll kind of look professional, but that's a pro and a con, in my opinion. Now, some of the cons that I found. This isn't quite a point of view video. It's what I'm seeing, but it leaves out my hands, and that's something I really enjoy about videos that use a GoPro. That's okay. Some smartphones don't screen record well, which could be a problem. My phone is very new and has a great processor, so it can screen record well. But if you're just using the camera app, it's not going to be a big deal. Now, I mentioned earlier that you might look professional with this setup, with the phone on top, and that can be a good or a bad thing. I actually had a moment where someone didn't like that I was taking pictures of them while I was out walking, and it's probably because my camera was so big and obvious. I had a giant smartphone on top of it recording. So if you want to be inconspicuous with your photography, you'd be better off just having the camera and a GoPro on your chest. But I don't have a GoPro chest mount, so this was the best option. Those are really the only cons I could find. I mean, my smartphone battery lasted the entire hour that I was out walking. Now, in terms of how you might do one of these voiceovers, that really depends on what you're making. Obviously, I'm talking about the tutorial aspects of the video, but if you were doing a voiceover like this, you could narrate what you were thinking. Right here, I was hoping for a nice framing of this lady walking down the street. I think it worked okay, but not quite what I was looking for. I edited most of all of these photos in Lightroom, but I'm not a big fan of how any of them turned out. I'm actually really digging my non-edited film photography photos, but these are all digital, so I'm not sure that I like them as much. But basically, I just walk around. There's this one photo that you might see if you keep watching. These three ladies are walking, and there's this shadow all around, and there's just this beam of light, and I cranked the shutter speed up so it'd be nice and dark and surrounding and contrasty. Took like 20 photos. In one photo, they were all just barely stepping out of the light, and I think it looked great. Another thing is, I took these all with my Canon M50, and I was using the kit lens, which, in my opinion, doesn't look that great. It could partially be the ND filter that's making me not a big fan of these images, or it could just be my editing style. Like this one, I don't like how I edited that, but now that it's done, I'm too lazy to go back and change it. Another thing you might notice is that I did a lot of low shutter speed photos, which I really enjoyed. I had the ND filter on, as I mentioned, which let me lower my shutter speed and get really blurry photos like one I'm about to take right here. There it is. That's one of my favorite photos. It's just slightly blurry, but it looks great. I talked over the part earlier where I took a picture of two people standing in a little island, and they were just completely still in the background, a car blurred past. That was probably my favorite photo, a aside from the photo of the ladies in the shadow, because that was also really great. But anyways, you can also not even do a voiceover if you don't want to. It's really soothing to me to just watch a street photography video with no voiceover, just the sounds of the street and the camera. So if that's something you wanted to do, it's a good option. Anyways, I'll outro this video, but since I'm here now, thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of the photos.
Thank you for watching. If you did enjoy, please consider leaving a like down below and subscribing. It always helps. We're already almost to 130 subscribers on this channel, which is absolutely crazy. In this video, you saw a lot of information, hopefully. Hopefully this video was helpful to you and you have an idea of how, at least how I would go about making a point of view street photography video. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.